said one last thing and I didn't mean it. My mission in life is to get you to cut faster and more accurately. It's something that I'm keep saying, you need to give a class on cutting.
Right.
And so here is my best advice. Don't use the lines on the mat and on your ruler. Pick one. You only need one measuring tool. Secondly, when you cut a strip and you don't want to cut a long strip.
When she says pick one, we really mean the ruler.
Yeah.
Yeah, because when people line up with the board, those are the people that have about six pieces up by the half the day. They should have a whole square up, and they don't, because they're carefully cutting every piece of fabric. So if you're having problems with that, she's here to teach you.
I am. Okay. The other thing is, and this is a really, really hot tip. I'm going to use you as a bad example. Don't do this. Don't cut strips that are inside. As soon as you move your strip, you've ruined the accuracy of your first cut, because she's going to have to move that back here, line it up again. So as soon as you cut a strip, cut it into squares, and move the square pile over here. Cut a strip, cut them up, because it will take you twice as long to do this as it would if you had just made each one of those a square. And yes, some of you are going to worry that it's the wrong color and you're going to waste fabric. Well, kids.
So you have some squares. You know, maybe this is the last quilt you will ever make in your entire life. This is the biggest waste in your, you know, but, you know, I think you'll make another quilt. And, you know, probably that square will go into that quilt.
But, you know, almost everybody has this tendency. What you need is your box of crayons here, ready to go to the wall. And so the less you move your fabric, the more accurate it'll be.
Okay.
Good? Yep. You're welcome. Anybody need one of these? They're not terribly helpful. It's just, it's kind of a mess.